In this episode of Star Hopping with Kissimmee Park Observatory, we'll look at the Canes Venatici region and show you how to find these beautiful deep sky objects. Messier 94, NGC 5033, and the Whale Galaxy, NGC 4631.
All right, let's go star hopping.
Hey, hello, hi, and welcome to episode 49 of Star Hopping with Kissimmee Park Observatory. I'm Dave Hearn, and I'm on pins and needles to be your host. In this series of programs, we'll show you the most beautiful sights in the night sky and explain exactly how to find them with your binoculars or your telescope. Oh, we're so close to our big episode 50 coming in 2 weeks. I can't believe we've completed that many episodes already. We're going to celebrate a little bit and look back at our joint experience that we've had in the last year and a half of star hopping. Also, I have some exciting announcements of some big changes coming to star hopping. Don't worry, they're all good. So I'll fill you in on all that stuff next time, so make sure that you subscribe here on our YouTube channel or on iTunes if you're a podcast listener. So on to this week's episode. I've been mentioning a little bit on social media that we're in galaxy hunting mode again this time of year. The constellations of Ursa Major, Canes Venatici, Leo, and Coma Berenices are just loaded with galaxies. And we've seen a lot of them already on star hopping, but there's still three really good ones that I haven't done before here, so I'm excited to show them to you tonight. So we'll be starting off with the easiest one, a big and bright galaxy that even those of you with smaller telescopes should have no problems locating. We'll talk about it right after this break. Stay tuned. Kissimmee Park Observatory would like to thank our wonderful supporters on Patreon. Your contributions will allow us to create and provide more quality astronomy content. We appreciate your generosity and support.
Hopping target number one.
Messier 94 is a massive galaxy right in the middle of the constellation of Canes Venatici. With a visual magnitude of 8.2, Messier 94 is an impressive object. It has a brilliant core, brightening to a hazy central nucleus, and it's surrounded by an elongated 14 arc minute disk. A series of knots on the east and southeast sides give you an inkling of a spiral pattern. It has tightly wound spiral arms, making it appear nearly spherical in small telescopes. The good news is that very close by, we have the bright second magnitude star, Core Corollae, that we can use as our home base for all of the star hops tonight. So let's start our galaxy hunt. Starting at the bright Core Corollae, move 2.5 degrees straight up to sixth magnitude, 10 Canum Venaticorum. Now make a hard left turn and move the same distance you just did, 2.5 degrees, directly to the left. At this point, you should see the bright glow of Messier 94 moving into your wide field eyepiece. In a smaller telescope, M94 appeared like a fuzzy star, but at magnitude 8.2, it would definitely show up in a 3-inch telescope or even your finderscope. M94 lies about 16 million light years distant, and it has a diameter of approximately 33,000 light years. We'll check out another large but a little fainter galaxy right in the neighborhood right after this message. Would you like to see the scripts, images, and star charts that I present in each episode of Star Hopping in written form? Well, you can. They're available in our Field Notes digital guides that we produce for each and every episode of Star Hopping. Field Notes guides are available right back to episode 1 of Star Hopping, and you can put them on your phone or tablet to take with you out to your favorite observing site. Our Field Notes are available in our digital store individually, in seasonal bundles, or by subscription, where you can receive these useful digital guides in your inbox, sent to you the same day as when we publish each new episode of Star Hopping. Check out our selection of Field Notes in our digital store by visiting kpobservatory.org/storefront.
Star hopping target number two.
NGC 5033 is a beautiful spiral galaxy just south of our home base star, Core Corollae. On our way to 5033, we'll pass another decent galaxy, NGC 5005, a ninth magnitude spiral. So NGC 5033 is a magnitude 10.8 spiral galaxy, has a length of 11 arc minutes, so its relatively large size and reasonable surface brightness make it a nice object that can be viewed and imaged by amateur astronomers. This may be a future target for me at the observatory. So let's locate NGC 5033. We'll start again at bright core coronae. Move about 3 degrees to the lower right to fifth magnitude, 14 Canem Venaticorum. Now move another 2 degrees to the left to find a sixth magnitude star. Now move 1 degree straight down and slightly right to another sixth magnitude star. As you pass about half the distance, you may find NGC 5005 that we mentioned earlier. If you find it, take note of the brightness. 5033 is a little fainter. So now move a quarter degree to the lower right, and you should see the soft glow of NGC 5033 moving into your wide field eyepiece. So our current target has a very bright nucleus and a relatively faint disk. In astrophotos, significant warping is visible in the southern half of the disk. NGC 5033 is a sprawling spiral galaxy with thick arms. This island universe is estimated to be 37 million light years away. So as usual, I've saved the best for last. A massive 17 minutes of arc-long galaxy with a close companion. We'll find them right after this break.
Star hopping target number 3.
The Whale Galaxy, NGC 4631, is a huge edge-on spiral galaxy in Canes Venatici. This galaxy is slightly distorted due to the gravitational interaction with its companion galaxy, NGC 4627, seen in this image here from KPO. The slightly distorted wedge shape gives NGC 4631 the appearance of a large fin that makes it look like a herring or a whale. This one was named Whale. I can definitely see the whale shape. So let's go on a whale hunt. Let's start again at bright core coronae. Move about 1.5 degrees to the upper right to fifth magnitude DT Canem Venaticorum. Now move a little over 2.5 degrees to the upper right to sixth magnitude AX Canem Venaticorum. Now move about the same distance to the upper right to a fifth magnitude star with a close sixth magnitude companion. Now move 1 degree straight down, and you'll see the large slash of light that is the Whale Galaxy moving into your wide field eyepiece. Isn't this thing a monster? I was very surprised when I was imaging it the first time at the observatory when that first subframe came up on the screen. The Whale Galaxy is an enormous spiral galaxy seen edge-on. It has a visual magnitude of 9.8, so it's decently bright, and it spans a massive 17 minutes of arc over half the diameter of the full moon. Well, we've seen another 3 great galaxy targets for our 49th episode of Star Hopping. We started out with bright Messier 94, found just at the upper left of our home base star, Core Coronae. Then we searched out the fainter NGC 5033 and its close companion, NGC 5005. That was your challenge object for this week. Finally, we finished up with the massive Whale Galaxy, NGC 4631. So make sure to stay tuned for our celebration episode 50 coming in 2 weeks from Star Hopping. We have some really exciting announcements to share with you at that time. It's going to be a great year. So that does it for this week's episode. You can find the show notes on our website at kpobservatory.org/SH049, where you can comment and leave any questions that you may have. You can also contact me personally on Twitter at StarhoppingMan, where I'd love to help you with any astronomy or observing questions. So feel free to reach out with your questions. I'm here to help. Well, thank you so much for joining me here, and I'll see you next time with more star hopping tips and tricks.
I'm Cassie, and I hope you've enjoyed star hopping around the Milky Way. We'll continue to bring you these video astronomy tutorials in the associated podcast every other week on Thursdays. They'll be designed to help you find deep sky objects that are up in the sky at the time we post them on the internet. The reason we create these videos and podcasts is to help beginning amateur astronomers learn the sky and get more enjoyment out of their telescopes and astronomy in general. If you have any requests for potential targets in the night sky that you would like to see us discuss, just let us know down in the comments section below or on our website blog. Don't miss our free field notes for this episode, basically the script of the show, with all the images and star charts we use for our star hopping activities. You can get them for free at kpobservatory.org/fieldnotes. If this is the first time you're checking out star hopping, and if you found this video useful, please consider subscribing to our channel by clicking the big yellow button, click the thumbs up on the video, and please share this tutorial out to your friends who like looking at stars. Also, as I just mentioned, please feel free to leave any question or comment below, and we'll be sure to respond quickly. Please follow KPO on Facebook, where we post all of our astronomical digital images, and keep everyone informed about upcoming astronomical events. We'd love to hear from you to discuss all this great stuff up in the sky. All the links to these places in cyberspace, including our website, kpobservatory.org, can be found below in the episode notes as well. And finally, if you feel this video provides you value, and if you'd like to see more, please consider supporting us on Patreon, where for a small amount per video, you can support our efforts, and help us make even more great astronomy tutorials, just like this one. So bye for now, and thank you for watching, and we'll see you next time on Star Hopping with Kissimmee Park Observatory.